morning, and thank you all for coming to join us today for the ribbon cutting ceremony of our new middle school. I'm Jeff Schoonover. I'm the.
Hey, Jeff.
Oh, there we go. Oh, I have to go this way. All right. I'm the proud superintendent of the Somerset Public Schools, and it's an honor for me to welcome you here today. All right. So we're going to get started with a couple of things.
The volumes are up.
I'll just try to speak loudly, and if this occasionally catches my voice, then great. I'd like to introduce George Andes, who's going to raise our flag. Maybe can you hear me if I just project?
Yes.
Thank you. Okay. All right, so George Andes helped us secure two flags, one from the that flew over the U.S. Capitol. He coordinated this with Congressman Auchincloss's office, and we also have a state flag that he helped secure through the help of Senator Rodericks that flew over our state house. George is going to raise the U.S. flag in just a minute. That flag will then be used, it'll be on permanent display in our middle school gym, along with the state flag that Senator Rodericks helped us get. So those will be there with plaques going forward. While George and his team raises the flag, I'd like to introduce Maggie LePage, one of our students, to sing the national anthem. Thank you, Maggie. Thank you, George. I'd like now to introduce our building committee chair, Victor Machado.
Good morning, everyone. What a beautiful morning for this celebration. It's hard to believe in a few minutes we'll be cutting a ribbon to officially open this state-of-the-art middle school, which will now be able to serve all of our middle-aged students for the next 50-plus years. I still remember when the school committee and the Board of Selectmen voted to submit a statement of interest to the MSBA back in March of 2016. 7.5 years later, Somerset has a school that we can all be proud of. After submitting the statement of interest to the MSBA, the MSBA did a site visit of our old school. Words that we would hear in the past, and hopefully never again: mold, leaks, stains on the ceiling tiles, air quality. Those were tough things to hear as a school committee member over and over again. After hearing the MSBA's feedback, we knew that a core building project was needed. I should acknowledge We would not be here today if it wasn't for the hard work of Superintendent Jeffrey Schoonover and our former business managers, Lindsay Albanez, our building and grounds, Carlos Campos, and our former principal, Pauline Camara, and their teams who spent numerous hours collecting all the data to submit the statement of interest. In 2017, the district resubmitted the SOI, the statement of interest, and we received an invitation by the MSBA to begin this new project. With the support of the town, we were able to secure $800,000 to study for a feasibility study at the annual town meeting. And our school committee formed a building committee. And let me introduce the members of this committee. When your name is called, if you could please walk up and so everyone can acknowledge you. Jennifer Ashley. Michael Patello. Kathleen Byers. Dr. Pauline Camara. Carlos Campos. Chris Gaudette. Elizabeth Haskell. Robert Lima. Dr. Kerry McKinnon. Carlton Medeiros. Stephen Medeiros. Nicole Mello. Cassie Monte. Nick Raffa. Kevin Scanlon. Alan Smith. Ron Taro. James Texera. Mark Alucci, and my right-hand man, Jeffrey Schoonover, our vice chairman. One of our first major decisions was to choose a owner's project manager and an architect. We interviewed many, but there was a clear choice of only one firm to represent both us as an OPM and architect. And we were very fortunate that they actually submitted an interest. First, our owner's project manager team from CGA, Dan Tavares. There I am. If you could step right up as well. Dan, if you could come up, please. And Mary Beth Carney. And our architect firm from AI3, once again, if you guys could come up, Troy Randall, Jonathan Quill, Darren Sawyer, and also everyone else from that team. As I mentioned, 7.5 years went through this building, multiple town votes. Some were very supportive, others the towns felt that they could no longer be squeezed because of the inflation. The inflation really caused some hardship. Like other school projects around the town, we were short by $9.9 million. Our building committee, our architect, went back to the drawing board. For 6 months, we reviewed different building designs and other options. Always in keeping in mind that we would not allow any cuts to impact the future of our learning. One of the best decisions that we made was move into a construction management at risk. And on December 12th, 2022, this committee voted to enter into agreement with Break Construction. I don't know if there are any members from Break Construction, but if so, if you could come up, because you were, I would like to let the community know what happened during the interview. Bray laid out a plan. Not only would we still be opening this building on time, but also keep the original design. At first, we were a bit concerned. Is it possible? Those concerns went away because 2 days later, Bray Construction had already mobilized and broke ground. two other individuals were very supportive of this project and should be acknowledged. They attended every meeting with us at the MSBA. Many times they were there before Jeff, Lindsay, and I would even arrive. First, our Senator Mike Rodericks. And our second, our State Representative Pat Haddad. I would ask you to all please keep Pat Haddad and her family in your prayers and thoughts tonight, because her family is dealing with a serious situation, and that is the only reason why she's not here supporting this opening. The reason why I mentioned them early on is because when we realized that we were about to lose all of our sports fields, our solar arrays, we quickly reached out to Mike and Pat once again. And they reached out to their colleagues on the Hill. With the support of the governor, Senate, and the House, they allocated $100 million to the MSBA so they could support 33 communities that had been impacted by the inflation costs. With this additional fund, in 2 years from now, we will officially be completed with this project with new sports fields, and the solar arrays will be back on this building to provide extra income towards our operating expenses. One thing that I learned about this project, timelines looks perfect on paper. For nearly 20 months since this construction has started, it has not been easy. Actually, it's been very stressful. We've had over 250 plus meetings. We have dealt with 9 months to a year worth of lead times. But most of all, this project in the last 20 months has had over 218,000 construction work hours, many change orders, and there are still yet to come. When you tour the school today, please keep it in mind that there are punch items that yet needs to be completed. A small amount of furniture hasn't arrived yet. Landscape has to be completed. But throughout this whole process of getting ready for today, our custodial team has been hard at work. When you're walking around, you may not see a completely clean school yet, but I guarantee you in December, it will be completed. When you're touring this place, remember, only 20 months ago, you would be standing in a parking lot, a baseball field, or a hill of grass. Before I end, I want to acknowledge my school committee members and selectmen, fellow selectmen, who have supported this project since day one. On the school committee, Michael Botello, Andrew Crook, Stu Maggiore, Laurie Rothwell, Melissa Terra, Chris Gaudette, Michael McDonald, Robert Gore, Shauna Geary, Chris Carville, Kim Ferreira, and Jen Ashley. And also, and from the Board of Selectmen, David Barraby, Lawn Lawless, Holly McNamara, Steve Monis, Alan Smith, Kathy Souza, Jake Vaught, and Jameson Souza. Another great partner is the MSBA. In my opinion, the Massachusetts School Building Authority is our best state agency. Under the leadership of our state treasurer, Deb Goldberg, and its board, the MSBA reviews every statement of interest to ensure that to ensure and protect that our limited funds are maximized for us taxpayers, all while still improving the school facilities throughout the Commonwealth. But most of all, lastly, I want to thank all of you, not for only attending today, but for your continued support in education in this town. You are the reason why we all show up to these meetings. Our students, when you're walking through here, look at the walls. they will not be mold. They might be dents, but that's the punchline on my items. They may still be missing some decals. But look at the walls. Look at the ceiling tiles. There are no leaks. There's no more mold in this building. And the air quality is outstanding. Thank you all for coming. At this time, I'm going to turn it back to Mr. Schoonover.
All right, hello again. This is a proud moment for our community, and I'm honored to stand before you as we celebrate a dream turned into reality. As Victor said, this work started about 8 years ago, when we first submitted the statement of interest to the MSBA. And there are so many people to acknowledge who contributed to this work along the way. And I apologize. I know I'll touch upon some of the same people who Victor just mentioned. But I do want to acknowledge my heartfelt gratitude to a number of those people, our dedicated community members, local leaders, teachers, students, families. Your unwavering support and commitment have been instrumental in bringing this vision to life. As Victor said, we had an amazing project management, design, and construction team. Our owners, project managers of CGA, Dan, Mary Beth, and Bill Fryer. As Victor said, our design team at AI3, spearheaded by Troy Randall, Darren Sawyer, Jonathan Quell, Heather Martins, and Tori Geyer, along with a larger contributing team. Our construction team at Brait Builders, specifically Gary Brait, Michael Brait, and Robert Brait. Our superintendent, Dan Perry, who is here today. Joe Amara and Kate Johnson and many others who worked on this project since we broke ground about 18 months ago. I want to thank School Building Committee Chair Victor Machado for selflessly and tirelessly leading us through this work, and all of the members of the Somerset Middle School Building Committee. To the faculty and staff of the middle school who contributed much time and effort to the design of this project, we wanted to ensure that teachers' voice was heard when we were constructing this project, when we were designing. And this started about 5 years ago with some visioning sessions that took place in the old building. And we've had countless meetings since. However, no person from the middle school was more instrumental in the work than our recently retired principal, Dr. Pauline Camara. She devoted countless hours to this project, and I cannot thank her enough for her significant contributions. Let's see. Thank you, Victor, for mentioning all of the school committee members and Board of Selectmen members who contributed to this project along the way. I do want to especially thank Alan Smith and Mark Iolucci for really participating faithfully in this work for the past several years and contributing so much to the project. I want to acknowledge members of the community and the Somerset Berkeley Education Foundation who really supported the project when it was being approved, specifically Sharon Sullivan Puccini, Shannon Martin, Melanie Hero, Kate Clood, Jameson Souza, Kate LePage, Jen Bailey, and Amy Allman. Our state leaders, Representative Haddad and Senator Rodericks, who represent Somerset so well and strongly advocate for us tirelessly, and help secure this additional funding, as Mr. Machado mentioned. This project would not have been possible without the MSBA and their financial support and expert guidance. Special thanks to MSBA Deputy CEO and Executive Director Mary Picchetti, Mass State Treasurer and MSBA Chair Deborah Goldberg, Matt Donovan, and everyone else, the whole team at the MSBA who's worked with us over these years. And there are so many others to thank, such as our Technology Director, Stephen Levesque, and his entire technology team who've spent the entire summer just preparing for the opening of school. To Mike Carrera, our Director of Facilities, and his custodial and maintenance team who have just worked endlessly to prepare for today. To our administrative team at the middle school, Dr. McKinnon, Cassie Monti, David Hines, who have just seemed like they don't leave this building or haven't left this building in the last several weeks, just preparing for the opening of school. And lastly, I want to thank our 8th grade peer mentors who will lead you shortly through the school. They provided tours to students this week for the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade orientations. They did a wonderful job, and they are excited to show you their school today. So this new facility represents more than just bricks and mortar. It is a promise of our future, to our future generations, a promise of an advanced learning environment where our students will have the resources they need to explore, innovate, and excel. And our teachers will have the resources they need to inspire and engage students. We have prioritized safety and health, ensuring that our children have a nurturing space to grow academically and personally. This school stands as a testament to what we can achieve when we work together with a shared purpose. To our students, this is your school. We hope it inspires you to reach new heights and chase your dreams with passion and perseverance. Thank you all once again for your support. Together, we are shaping the future of Somerset. I'd now like to introduce Senator Michael Rodericks.
Thank you, Jeff. Good morning, everyone. It's so great to be here, and I always say ribbon cuttings are so much more fun than ground breakings. We don't have a shovel to go home with, but we have the experience knowing that the result of all of the hard work and efforts by so many people proved once again to be worth it. This is an amazing, I just had a great tour with some of the student mentors. This is an amazing school that will fully prepare these young students for the 21st century to be our next leaders. I do want to just mention a couple individuals. One who was mentioned earlier, one of my best friends and partners, Representative Pat Haddad, who sends her regrets for not being able to be here. We were literally at 6:16 this morning, we were texting each other, and she's where she's supposed to be with her family right now. And I also want to mention my partner in government, the Treasurer, Deb Goldberg, because as Jeff alluded to, it became evident about 2 years ago that many of the school building projects that have gone through the MSBA process and signed the contract and the agreements with the MSBA were suffering from what we call post-pandemic supply-side inflation. That inflation, as a result of supply chain disruptions during the pandemic, has caused great stress amongst communities to the tune of about $300 million statewide. About $40 million of that are in schools and communities that I represent. Somerset with the middle school and Diamond Vocational High School in Fall River that also services Somerset. And the taxpayers and citizens of my community were going to be on the hook for an additional $40 million during for that construction. So working with Treasurer Goldberg, we put a plan together that we would partner with our local communities, that I will do what I can in the legislature to appropriate $100 million. In working with Representative Haddad and my friends in the legislature, we were successful in that further $100 million appropriation, and that Treasurer Goldberg will go back to the table and leverage another $100 million in additional bonding opportunities so that we will partner equally with our local communities, and we were successful. And that the result of which is that this school is built, and the taxpayers of the citizens of Somerset are not greatly impacted. So thank you all for your patience. Thank you all for your commitment to ensuring that Somerset has the best schools in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, that has the best schools in the United States of America. And it's all because of all of you. So thank you all very much.
Okay, I'd now like to introduce the Deputy CEO and Executive Director of the MSBA, Mary Piketty.
Good morning, everyone. I want to congratulate Somerset on behalf of Treasurer Goldberg, Chief Executive Officer Jim McDonald, and all of us at the MSBA. Congratulations for being here today at the school opening. It's a wonderful school, and I'm sure you're all there eager to get inside and have a tour. This new school design was well planned. It included many visioning sessions and focused on key design principles. Always important is the educational plan and what we are trying to offer to our students. We certainly have been pleased to partner with this district and its project team, CGA, AI3, and Great Builders. There you go, the notes. Okay. And in conclusion, All right. So when COVID hit and its aftermath, as you've heard, many school projects around the state were challenged by unexpected high increases in construction costs. But the Somerset team did not surrender, and that is why we are here today. Without the additional funding needed to continue with the original plans, they rolled up their sleeves and got to work. And as you've heard, the partnership that they made with their design team, their OPM, and their contractor have brought you the building that you all wanted and voted for. I certainly need to thank our partners for their continued support from the legislature, as you heard from Chairman Rodericks today. With his advocacy and leadership and many others, they passed legislation in 2023 that allowed for additional funding to go out to those 30 districts who suffered during the aftermath of high increases. And certainly we were happy to do our part, and the MSBA board was able to approve an additional $6.8 million in funding for the town of Somerset. Certainly, our thanks always goes to the community. As you've heard here today, there are so many to thank. There are so many that takes to be have and make a successful project and get to today. It's our honor to be here with you today. And I like to look over, especially come and look over at the faces of the students, because that's what makes it all worthwhile for all of us. So congratulations, enjoy today.
Okay, now I'd like to introduce Dr. Kerry McKinnon, principal of Somerset Middle School.
Good morning. Today marks a significant milestone for our school community. We gather here to celebrate the grand opening of our new Somerset Middle School with immense pride and heartfelt joy. This moment is not just a ribbon-cutting ceremony. It is a testament to the dedication, hard work, and vision that have brought us to this point. I extend my deepest gratitude to all those who made our new middle school a reality, an environment where our students can thrive. As we stand here today, it is important to remember that this new building is more than just a physical space. It is a state-of-the-art facility designed to enhance our students' learning experiences, foster creativity and innovation, and provide a setting where every child can explore, grow, and achieve their fullest potential. In this facility, our students can engage in multimodal learning experiences permeated with new instructional technologies. The new SMS will be where students' curiosity is nurtured, their talents are celebrated, and their dreams are encouraged. Today, as we cut this ribbon, we are not just opening doors, we are opening a future full of possibilities for our students. To our current and future students, the new Somerset Middle School is a gift from all of us to you. Embrace it with the enthusiasm and wonder you bring to every day. Use it as a tool to learn, explore, and build the future you envision for yourselves. Remember that this is a space created with you in mind, a place where your potential is limitless. Here's to the countless opportunities the new Somerset Middle School will provide and the bright futures that lie ahead for each of our students. Let's look forward to the great things from this new chapter for Somerset Middle School. Thank you. I'd now like to call Mr. Victor Machado up to cut the ribbon.
How are you?
Well, how are you doing?
So we're going to start the tours. Mrs. Monty will start to organize tour groups with our SMS mentors leading the tours to the new building. Welcome.